In this video, we will consider some problems on Milne-Thomson method. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to construct analytic function by using Milne-Thomson method. Pause this video and write down the answer for the question: what is the formula for the derivative of an analytic function f of z? I hope all of you have written the answer. Now the answer is: the derivative of any analytic function f of z is given as f dash of z is equal to ux plus I into vx. And this derivative also has the another form. Since f of z is an analytic, therefore its real and imaginary part satisfies the CR equations ux equal to vy and uy equal to minus vx. If we replace ux by vy and vx by minus uy, we get the same derivative in the another form as f dash of z equal to vy minus I into uy. Let us consider one example. Find the analytic function f of z whose imaginary part is e raised to x into x sin y plus y cos y. Solution: here we have given the imaginary part, therefore we will denote it by v. Step number 1, we are differentiating the given function v partially with respect to x and y. So let us differentiate first v partially with respect to x, treating y constant, therefore we get vx equal to. Now here we can see that this is the product of two functions of x. Therefore, we use the product rule to differentiate it. That is, first of all, we will write e raised to x as it is and then differentiate the second function. Now here, in the first term, sin y is constant and the derivative of x is 1 plus, in the second term, x is not involved, therefore, its derivative is 0 plus, write down the second term x into sin y plus y cos y as it is, and the derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. After taking e raised to x common from these two terms, we get e raised to x into sin y plus x sin y plus y cos y. Let us differentiate v partially with respect to y, treating x constant. We get vy equal to, now the first term is of e raised to x, which is constant. Let us write it as it is, into inside the bracket. While differentiating with respect to y, x is constant and the derivative of sin y is cos y plus. Now in the second term, we can see that this is what the product of two functions of y. Therefore, in order to differentiate it, we have to use the product rule. Writing y as it is, derivative of cos y is minus sin y plus cos y as it is, and the derivative of y is 1. Now after simplifying it, we get e raised to x into x cos y minus y sin y plus cos y. Step number 2, we know the formula for the derivative of an analytic function f of z, that is f dash of z equal to ux plus I vx. Let us call it as equation number 1. Now, in the step number 1, we have obtained the expression for vx and vy. And we can see that the derivative contains the term ux, that is the partial derivative of u with respect to x, which is not known to us. Now here, now our aim is to replace this unknown function in terms of the known function. In order to replace it, in the step number 3, we are using CR equations. The CR equations are given by ux equal to vy and uy equal to minus vx. Now here, ux is vy, replace in the equation number 1 ux by vy, we get equation number 1 as f dash of z equal to vy plus I into vx. The content involved in the right hand side is known to us. Let us replace vy and vx by its expression. We get this function. Now, to have the right hand side as a function of z, let us put x equal to z and y equal to 0 on the right hand side of equation 2. Now we get f dash of z is equal to e raised to z into z cos 0 minus 0 into sin 0 plus cos 0 plus I into e raised to z inside the bracket sin 0 plus z into sin 0 plus 0 into cos 0. That is, we get f dash of z equal to e raised to z as it is into, we know that cos 0 is 1, therefore z into 1 is z, and here 0 into sin 0 is 0 plus cos 0 is 1, therefore it is plus 1 plus, now here we can see that sin 0 is 0, again here sin 0, it is also 0. And 0 into cos 0 is 0. It means this total bracket has the value 0. Therefore, the second term is not written here. Now, we have obtained the right hand side as a simple function of z. Let us integrate the above equation with respect to z to get f of z. Now, integrating with respect to z, we get integration of f dash of z is f of z is equal to integration of e raised to z into z plus 1 dz plus c, integration constant. Now here we can see that this is the product of two functions of z. Therefore, the generalized rule of integration is used to evaluate this integral. We will consider z plus 1 as the first function and e raised to z as the second function. Now write down the first function as it is, and the integration of a raised to z is a raised to z minus, let us differentiate the first function z plus 1 with respect to z, its derivative is 1, into one more time let us integrate e raised to z, we get e raised to z plus c. After simplifying it, we get the final answer f of z as z into e raised to z plus c. This is the required analytic function f of z. Let us consider one more example. Find the analytic function f of z whose real part is sin 2x upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x. Also find imaginary part. Solution: as it is a real part, we will denote it by u. Step number 1, let us differentiate u partially with respect to x. Now here we can see that u is provided in terms of a rational function, and the numerator as well as denominator contains x. Therefore, to differentiate u partially with respect to x, we have to use u by v rule. Now the rule is, write denominator as it is and differentiate the numerator. Now the numerator is sin 2x, its derivative is cos 2x into 2 minus, write numerator sin 2x as it is into differentiating denominator with respect to x. Now it is a function of y, therefore its derivative with respect to x is 0 minus, now the derivative of cos 2x is minus sin 2x into 2 divided by denominator square. Now after simplification, we get 2 hyperbolic cos 2y into cos 2x minus 2 cos square 2x minus 2 sin square 2x upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x bracket square. Now, in the second and third term, we can see that it is possible to take minus 2 common. And after taking minus 2 common, the expression remained in the bracket is cos square 2x plus sin square 2x, and its value is 1. Therefore, we get ux equal to 2 hyperbolic cos 2y into cos 2x minus 2 upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x bracket square. And similarly, differentiating u partially with respect to y, we get the derivative minus 2 sin 2x into hyperbolic sin 2y upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x bracket square. Now let us use the formula for the derivative of f of z, that is f dash of z equal to ux plus ivx. Let us call it as equation number 1. Here vx is not known to us. Therefore, let us use the CR equations. The CR equations are ux equal to vy and uy equal to minus vx. Now, here the second result is useful. We can replace vx as minus uy. Therefore, equation number 1 becomes f dash of z equal to ux minus I uy. And we are knowing the expressions for ux and uy. After substituting it, we get this equation. Let us call it as equation number 2. Now to get this right hand side as a function of z, let us substitute x equal to z and y equal to 0 on the right hand side of above equation 2. Now we get f dash of z equal to 2 into, if we put y is 0, it is hyperbolic cos of 0 and hyperbolic cos of 0 is 1, into cos of 2z minus 2 divided by, again this hyperbolic cos 2y is hyperbolic cos 0 and its value is 1 minus cos of 2z bracket square plus. Now here we can see that if I put y equal to 0 here, it is hyperbolic sine 0 and its value 0. Therefore, the imaginary part totally vanishes. Therefore, we can write here plus I into 0. Now, after taking minus 2 common from the first term in the numerator, we get it as minus 2 into 1 minus cos of 2z upon 1 minus cos 2z bracket square. Let us remove 1 minus cos 2z from the numerator and denominator. Now, we get f dash of z equal to minus 2 upon 1 minus cos of 2z. And again we know that 1 minus cos 2z is nothing but 2 sin square z. Now we can remove this 2 and we get f dash of z as minus 1 upon sin square z. And again we know that 1 upon sin is nothing but cosec. Therefore we can write minus 1 upon sin square z as minus cosec square z. Now the right hand side is obtained as a function of z. Integrating with respect to z, we get, now the integration of f dash is f of z is equal to, minus is written outside the integral, and the integration of cosec square z dz plus integration constant c. And we know that integration of cosec square is minus cot z, and this plus c as it is, and finally we get it as cot z plus c. Now this is the required analytic function. Now to find the imaginary part from this analytic function, we will write f of z as u plus iv, and it is, we have obtained as cot z, and we know that cot z is nothing but cos z upon sin z. Again z is nothing but x plus iy, therefore we get it as cos of x plus iy upon sin of x plus iy, and it is equal to, let us multiply and divide by sin of x minus iy. Now we will get this expression. Now we know the identity, cos a into sin b is nothing but 1 by 2 sin of a plus b minus sin of a minus b. Now we will get this expression, and in the denominator also we can use the identity that sin a into sin b, that is equal to 1 by 2 cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. Now we will get this expression after applying this identity. Now this 1 by 2 will be removed and we get this numerator as sin 2x minus sin 2iy upon cos of 2iy minus cos of 2x, that is equal to sin 2x as it is, and we know that sin 2iy is nothing but I into hyperbolic sin of 2y divided by, and cos of 2iy is nothing but hyperbolic cos of 2y minus this cos 2x as it is. Now if we separate it from the numerator, we get u plus iv equal to sin 2x upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x plus I into minus hyperbolic sin 2y upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x. Now we can see that this is what the given real part in the problem, and therefore definitely it is the required imaginary part. Therefore after comparing, we get the imaginary part V as minus hyperbolic sin 2y upon hyperbolic cos 2y minus cos 2x.